It's I'm Joe Buttons, by the way.
All right.
this is one of my own inventions. It's a mic'd up jew's harp, and it just blows you away when you play it. When it's mic'd up, obviously it's a lot louder than that. What more do you want?
I love it.
Actually, now listen, there's been a real problem. We've been very worried for a while that bluegrass just hasn't been commercially viable enough, and it's not popular enough, and so we've done something about it, actually.
We put our heads together.
We put our heads together, and we decided that it was a bit too what would you describe it as? Confrontational, I suppose.
Yeah.
It's not really subliminal enough.
Yeah, what you really need, I mean, if you want to make music popular, it's got to be subliminal. It's got to be everywhere, hasn't it? It's got to be in supermarkets, in elevators.
Elevators, yes.
So what we've come up with is our own special music. Who said that?
It's actually called Bluzak.
Bluzak.
Yes, this is elevator bluegrass.
This is elevator bluegrass, so...
And I hope you enjoy it. And rush out and buy lots of groceries. So this, well, you'll understand it. Actually, you're probably one of the few audiences who will. Here we go. Cruising down the shopping aisle.
Gonna listen to a story about a man named Pedro. Poor villager, barely kept his family, Pedro. Then one day, he was shooting at some weeds, and he said, this will pay for all my needs. Well, that is green gold, marijuana. Next thing you know, Pedro's a millionaire. His muchacho say, hey Pedro, move on out of there. Said California is the place you ought to be. So they loaded up the boat and they sailed for Beverly Hills, that is. Swimming pools, movie stars, street violence, political unrest. Hey, muchachos, this is just like home. Ole. If anybody was listening. Doesn't make the music popular, nothing will.
Yes. As you can... that's not on the new cassette, no. That's on the next one that's coming up, which is sort of like part two, and you won't get it unless you buy the first one.
Yeah.
Just won't make any sense, will it, Tony?
No. There's all these subliminal messages on the first one that make the second one incredibly enjoyable, so...
Yeah. Actually, we might do one off our cassette. What do you think?
Good idea.
That is a good idea, just, you know, to encourage you all. Not that we'd want to be taking your money. This is one called Salt Creek, which was originally called Salt River, but then Bill Munro recorded it and called it Salt Creek, and he's been getting the royalties on it ever since. Yeah. Okay. Going for time up here. We're still okay, are we? Okay.
Let's stay all night, eh? Well, we're going to stay until each and every one of you have our tape there, no?
All right, now. Well, we've spent the whole night, the parts that I've heard of the night, and it's been fantastic, actually. Haven't heard any Hank.
No.
Haven't heard a single Hank song. That's a good idea. Okay.
We're waiting for that.
We always like to play requests. This one is... we're going to get Tony to sing it, so that sort of sums it up. Well, I'm going to get Tony to sing it. I'm used to... And yeah, I'll just stick my teeth back in. Right. We normally play in another band called Sleight of Hand, which is a bluegrass band down south, and we've got a very silly bass player who sings the very high harmony in this, so just please imagine him. Thank you.
And get your hankies out, because this is a real tearjerker.
And there's room on the dance floor if you would like to waltz. Tear to your throat and a lump to your eye, that's on wood, wouldn't it?
Jenga.
Oh, yeah, we might do a Jenga Reinhardt tune called one of his, it's probably in French.
Stomping at Decker.
Stomping at Decker, which is a record company, yeah.
You can't read my writing.
Is that writing, isn't it?
Whenever you're ready. Whenever. Fasten your seatbelts.
One, two. Thank you.
Thank you.
Terry and Dave, we've got a bunch of fellas that you normally see sitting around the campfires having a good time and having a bit of a laugh, chaff, poke the poop at. Tonight they're going to try and do it seriously. Obviously you know who cleans the toilets. Ken has written back to a few of us. He sent over these wonderful books. If there's as much information in there as what there is weight, you're going to be able to play claw hammer, banjo, or finger picking guitar after learning one of these. If you want to buy one of these books are available through Jamie and Julie for $20 each. And I'll be having a bit of a peek at them later myself. These fellas up here, are we ready, Phil?
Just waiting for the bass.
Thank you much for coming, and we'll leave you with Bungee and the boys.
Hey, going great.
Okay, it's really great to be here. It's a tough act to follow, those fellas, weren't they? Great.
Impossible act to follow.
Yeah. No, we actually get to follow because we got a banjo. Fancy having a bluegrass festival without a banjo player up
there. And we got the big bass.
And a bass. The bull fiddle.
But we're missing the saxophone. Do you have a saxophone in this little band?
No sax, please. We're British, that's right. We're going to do a tribute song to Bill Munro. It's a great old tune called I'm Coming Back, But I Don't Know When. B flat.
After this, he might be right.
Introduce a few of these fellas here. This character on my left, right, that's right, yeah. Here's the incomparable Bungee Nickel. Travelled all the way from Nambour, can you imagine that, to be here? Nambour. The Bunge is a legend in his own mind.
And his lunchbox.
Yeah, but he actually lost his mind. But the changes have been so subtle that nobody's really noticed. Ah, oh dear.
I'm be nice part. To me,
I
Dave.
Know, yeah. Bunge's good, mate. He doesn't mind. He knows I doesn't really mean it, doesn't I? Phil McLaren over there on the far left. Phil lives in Gympie. He's the pale one of the crew because he grows mushrooms for a living. It's true.
He's a real fun guy.
Fun guy.
Thanks, Bunge.
No worries, mate.
Phil and I met here a couple of years ago and we got to talking about things. We decided to get together and form a band so we could indulge our two great, I guess they're passions, aren't they? The gospel and bluegrass music. So we're going to do a gospel song for you. Terry's going to sing it. This is Terry Contini. If you don't know Terry, well, you just don't know bluegrass around here because, mate, he'll drive 100 miles to go to a jam, this boy.
And this is old Dave Hart on the banjo. Who are we going to bash later?
Ah, mate. Someone's got to have broad shoulders in the band. That's me.
Are you ready?
This is called Going Up on the Mountain.
I'm going up on the mountain. I'm going up on the mountain, ain't coming down till morning. I'm going up on the mountain, ain't coming down in chains.
I'll travel that narrow way, get down on my knees and I will pray. I will travel on that narrow way, get down on my knees and pray. I'm going up
on the mountain, ain't coming down till morning.
I'm going up
on the mountain, ain't coming down in chains.
I'm going up
on the mountain, ain't coming down till morning.
I'm going up
on the mountain, ain't coming down in chains, ain't coming down
in chains.
This is a tune written by Ralph Stanley.
Ralph.
Ralph.
Ralph the Mount.
Yay! It's called Rank Strangers. It's in the key of F, a great one for Spain.
Life's early dawn, I was happy and free. I looked for my friends, but I never could find them. I found they were all rank strangers to me.
Everybody I met
seemed to be a rank stranger.
Seemed to be a
stranger, I ain't stranger.
No mother or dad.
No mother or dad.
Not a friend could I see.
Not a friend could I see.
They knew not my name.
They knew not my name.
And I knew not their faces.
And I knew not their faces.
Found they were old.
I found they were old. Rang strangers to me.
They'll all move away, said the voice of the stranger. A beautiful home by the bright crystal sea. We'll meet them someday up there in heaven, where no one will be. Rang strangers to me. Everybody I'm mother or dad,
no mother or dad,
not a friend could I see,
not a friend could I see,
they knew not my name,
they knew not my name,
and I knew not their faces,
and I knew not their faces,
I found they were old.
You got a B-flat, Bunge.
You got one of them, I know. You've been using it a lot, Bunge.
Oh, I have.
Even when I...
What is it?
This is another old bluegrass standard. It's called Blue Ridge Cabin Home. This old mountainside where I wandered when I was a boy. And my heart turned back to that old mountain shack and those Blue Ridge hills far away.
Well, I love those hills of old Virginia, from those Blue Ridge hills I did roam. When I die, won't you bury me on the mountain, far away to my Blue Ridge mountain home.
That ramshackle shack and those Blue Ridge hills far away. And my mother and dad, they lay there to rest. They're sleeping in peace together now.
Well, I love those hills of old Virginia, from those Blue Ridge hills I did roam. When I die, won't you bury me on the mountain, far away to my Blue Ridge mountain home. From those Blue Ridge hills I did roam. When I die, won't you bury me on the mountain, far away in my Blue Ridge mountain home.
Here's trouble, here's trouble. Dave's getting the fiddle.
Ooh, look out.
They probably
that's
believe
the
you.
That's
hey?
The front, Dave. That's the front.
Is there people out there? Oh, that, right. I don't know how I'm going to do this, but I'll just shift that a fraction. This tune we're going to play for you now started out as a ragtime piano piece. Anyway, we're going to attempt it.
He's ready to.
It's called Ragtime Annie. Banjo. We're going to do a great old
banjo
tune. No, it's not. This is another one of our, am I allowed to say it, most requested songs, Phil?
It's on our cassette that we haven't done yet. The copies are going free.
Well, in the same key, that's great. This is called Washed in the Blood. Great old gospel song, this one. Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood, in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless, are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the by the Savior's side? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in the crucified? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood, in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless, are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? There's plenty more of that down at the Blue Bus.
All right, Bungee and the boys. See you, Bungee. See you, boys. Fantastic. All right, put your hands together for the Skinny Dudes. This is the one band in the country for which I'm too fat to join.
Good on you, Graham. We'd like to do a Doc Watson little number just to warm up on.
Sparkling eyes things.
It's been a big session.
It still is.
One, two, three.
Those pretty blue eyes that I sparkle with love, send down to me from heaven above. And if I had wings like a beautiful dove, I'd fly away to the girl I love. There's a ramshackle shack down in old Caroline, and it's calling me back to that sweetheart of mine. Oh, those pretty blue eyes I long to see down in old Caroline, there long to be. Those pretty blue eyes that sparkle with love, sent down to me from heaven above. And if I had wings like a beautiful dove, I'd fly away to the girl I love. Sing love songs and she would say, my love for you can never die. Then we bid farewell, such a sad goodbye. Those pretty blue eyes that sparkle with love, sent down to me from heaven above. And if I had wings like a beautiful dove, I'd fly away girl I love. When it's harvest time down in old Caroline, I'll be drifting back to that sweetheart of mine. Spend the rest of my days with the girl I love, with the help of Lord up in heaven above. Those pretty blue eyes that sparkle with love, sent down to me from heaven above. And if I had wings like a beautiful dove, I'd fly away to the girl I love. Those pretty blue eyes that sparkle with love, sent down to me from heaven above. And if I had wings like a beautiful dove, I'd fly away to the girl I love. I'd fly away. Girl, I love.
We're warming up.
Thank you.
Here's your classic cheating song. The guy got cheated on.
It's bright up here, isn't it?
A song called Sleep With One Eye Open. 1, 2, 3.
Well, I just found out today a little game you play when I've been sleeping all my life away. You've been stepping, so they say, between midnight and day. I'm gonna sleep when I open from now on. Honey, from now on.
From now on.
All night long.
All night long.
You won't have a chance to treat your daddy wrong. You've been stepping, so they say, between midnight and day. I'm gonna sleep with one eye open from now on.
Some more mandolin.
Oh, there's a honky tonk down the road, just about a mile or so. Well, I understand that's where you spend your time. Now, honey, I got news for you. Your little game, it's true. From now on, begging your golden toe the line. Honey, from now on.
From now on.
All night long.
All night long.
You won't have a chance to treat your daddy wrong. You've been stepping, so they say, between midnight and day. I'm gonna sleep with one eye open from now on. Wise, running around with other guys. You were leaving me to spend my time alone. Now, honey, I got news for you. Little game, it's true. You start a little game that two can play. Honey, from now on.
From now on.
All night long.
All night long.
You won't have a chance to treat your daddy wrong. You've been stepping, so they say, between midnight and day. I'm gonna sleep with one eye open from now on.
Thank you. We'll just go out with a bit of a hillbilly fiddle tune, Bill Cheatham.
Drugs are starting to take effect. That's a hard act to follow, the skinny tees. I think they're coming back, and they're going to have Mr. Ian Tredinnick. Now, here's a fella who goes back a fair way in my history. Once upon a time when I used to play rock and roll at the local pub three nights a week. Somebody said to me, have a listen to this album, and it was an album that was done down in Sydney with people like John Cain and Chris Duffy, a couple of guys from America, Dave Bromberg and various other fellas, Stacey Phillips, and the singer on that album was a fella called Ian Tredinnick, and in those days he had a dirty great big beard like this. He was a handsome looking gent, but somebody got to him with a razor, and this is the result. He can still sing, and he's still one of the best bluegrass players and singers in the country. Put your hands together for Ian Tredinnick. And he's going to have the skinny dudes to back him up.
In G,
yeah.
Here's one I've never done before.
No, this is one we just check, 1, 2 and all that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
keep running right along with all the traditional bluegrass songs. Here's one that Chris probably hasn't heard before and doesn't even know, but we just made it up as we go. It's a Del McCoury, so it's probably a Bill Monroe tune song, and sung by Del McCoury. It's called The Prisoner Song.
Meet me out in that moonlight alone. I have a sad story to tell you, must be told in that moonlight alone. If I was a ship on the ocean, all covered with silver and gold, I'd sail my love to my darling, and there I'd be never to hold. So meet me tonight, Lord, meet me. Meet me out in that moonlight alone. I have a sad story to tell you, must be told in that moonlight alone. Meet me out in that moonlight alone. Oh, I have a sad story to tell you, must be told in that moonlight alone.
Thank you. That's the attempt at the high lonesome sound. How lonesome sound. What was that? What was that? We don't know that one. This could be tricky, seeing as though we've got three tunes. What was that one in B? Not the Children of Crime.
Oh, yeah.
So we do it in B flat. Yeah, that's it. So let me wish you love and wealth.
B flat,
huh? Okay, I'll find it. Start this off.
Darling, I'm all alone in a little mountain home. It's lonely, cold, and love is now inside. Oh, the child is foul of love. Life's the only one short you. Then you went away to be another's bride. Never know the pain that I felt the day you left. Should you ever wed again, let me wish you love and well. Same old whippoorwill breaks the silence on the hill as I stand and gaze upon that shaded wall where your picture used to hang in the little golden frame, and the memories of your smile I still recall.
You never know the pain that I felt the day you left. Should you ever wed again, let me wish you love and well.
Thank you. we've worked hard at these tunes, haven't we? Especially
hard,
this
hard
one.
To remember.
How about your favourite and mine? Sweet Little Miss Blue Eyes. Do you want to do that?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
In G. In G.
Here's one we're just trying now. And admitting it.
Who makes me forget all the other girls I met? Sweet little Miss Blue Eyes, who's sweeter to me than she really ought to be? Sweet little Miss Blue Eyes, little Miss Blue Eyes looks good. I'm gonna take her to the neighborhood. I'm gonna make every girl in town jealous when she's around. I'm a working the line, 'cause I'm glad that she's mine. I'm living in paradise. I know I can't go wrong, I'm just stringing along with sweet little Miss Blue Eyes. Forget all the other girls I met. Sweet little Miss Blue Eyes, who's sweeter to me than she really ought to be? Sweet little Miss Blue Eyes, little Miss Blue Eyes looks so good. I'm gonna take her to the neighborhood. I'm gonna make every girl in town jealous when she's around.
All right.
I'm glad that she's mine, 'cause I'm walking the line. I'm living in paradise. I know I can't go wrong, just stringing along with sweet little Miss Blue Eyes, with sweet little Miss Blue Eyes.
Okay. You want to do one more for luck? What was the other one?
Here's the best run.
The what one?
The best run.
The best run. Oh. Well, that could be Don't Let Your Deal Go Down, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, we'd like to finish up an old Latin Strokes tune or song or something called Don't Let Your Deal Go Down.
1, 2, 3.
That gal of mine, she was standing in the door. She said, honey, I'll be such a long time gone, you'll never see your gal no more. Don't let your deal go down, never let your deal go down. Don't let your deal go down till your last gold dollar is gone. Headed down that railroad track, she said, honey, I'll be such a long time gone, you'll never see your gal no more. Don't let your deal go down, never let your deal go down. Don't let your deal go down till your last gold dollar is gone. Down that old railroad track, I'm gonna take my blues away. If these doggone blues don't leave me now, I'm gonna rock away from here. Don't let your deal go down, never let your deal go down. Don't let your deal go down till your last gold dollar is gone. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Chris.
Beautiful at first.
She's blonde.
Been a big weekend. Mrs. Maggie Adney. Just so none of you guys out there get any ideas. To her right. To my right. Jeff Adney.
Thank you. Thank you.
Extraordinaire.
Thank you, viewers.
And you all know Mr. Graham Hughes here. And they've all generously put their time for these songs here tonight. The first one we're going to do is a Laurie Lewis song, and it's called Hills of My Home. And here
and
we go.
And this is Amanda Gilmour, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, Amanda Gilmour.
One, two,
thank you.
Three.
We're going to hear from the beautiful Maggie now. She's going to sing a song called Steel Rails. We got it from Alison Krauss. I don't know who wrote it.
If I really had you once, then I'll have you when I'm gone. Whistle blowing, blowing lonesome in my mind, calling me along that never-ending metal line. Steel rails, chasing sunshine round the bend, winding through the trees like a ribbon in the wind. I don't mind not knowing what lies down the track. I'm looking out ahead to keep my mind from turning back. songs I've known before. I've lost count of the hours, days and times. Rhythm of the rails keeps the motion in my mind. Steel rails chasing sunshine round the bend, winding through the trees like a ribbon in wind. I don't mind not knowing what lies down the track. I'm looking out ahead to keep my mind from turning back. In my mind, steel rails chasing sunshine round the bend, winding through the trees like a ribbon in the wind. I don't mind not knowing what lies down the track. I'm looking out ahead to keep my mind from turning back.
Tune that Maggie, a song Maggie, Mandy has written.
Thank you, Jeff.
I'm sorry, I'll get your name right.
talented people get up here and do their stuff. Thanks very much, everybody.
There are so many good players here tonight. I'm going to do a short little bit of rag and then I'm off.
Put your hands together for the Moreton Bay Band.
Yon Barleycorn is a hero bold as any in the land. His age has stood for ages a good and shall do so again. His greens all rich and green. The crops they bear with goodly cheer, but fit to serve the queen. Hey, John Barleycorn, oh, John Barleycorn, old and young his praises sung, John Barleycorn. The lord and all is at castle tall, the squire in stately home. The rich by name, in birth and fame, on John for succor calls. Hey, John Barleycorn, oh, John Barleycorn,
Johnny Young his praises sung, John Barleycorn. To mix the trouble, the world rejoice, gives warmth in the winter's cold. Make old men young, and weak men strong, and all men brave and bold. Hey, John Barleycorn, oh, John Barleycorn, old and young, his praises sung, John Barleycorn. Give me me native and that brown ale, all other drinks I'll scorn. For Aussie beer's the best I fear, me own John Barleycorn. Hey, John.
That was all about drinking or brewing a beer. Thank you.
French Canadian song. I'm going to get it right yet.
We're on. Good evening. Hello, hello, hello.
Thank you.
We've come up all the way from beautiful sunny Canberra. Yes, we've got our lovely suntan. Did anybody see Tony's legs earlier? They were a real treat, weren't they, eh?
I'm going to put my shorts back on if you like.
We're going to start with a couple of tunes from New England, written by a fiddle player called Rodney Miller. And these are two tunes he wrote for his daughter many years ago. First one's called Elvira, and that goes into another tune called Asher. So, without further ado, here we go.
Thank you.
a bit of bluegrass.
1, 2, 3.
As you read this letter that I write to you, sweetheart, I hope you understand. You're the only one I love. Please forgive me if you can. Sweetheart, I'm begging you to come home tonight. I'm so blue and all alone. Promise that I'll treat you right. Love, oh love, bring some home. Your baby's hungry, sick and cold. As hard I'm begging you to come home tonight. I'm so blue and all alone. I promise that I'll treat you right. Love, oh love, please come home. Said I treat you right. Love, oh love, please come home.
Oh, thank you. We organised to do those two tunes. We haven't got the phone, so what we're going to do now? What are we going to do?
Well, I think we should do a little... actually, we both play in a band down in Canberra called Straight Ahead. And I don't know if anybody's heard of...
You have? Oh, well, isn't that...
Oh, how wonderful. We just happen to have some straight ahead merchandise here with us.
We do too, yeah. Actually, we've done very well. We've done two whole numbers without mentioning our cassette. And that's
a world record.
That is a world record. But, man, straight ahead, we've just finished recording a new album, and on it we conclusively prove that hard rock developed in Ireland many years ago. And I think we should do that, don't you?
Oh, that's probably a good idea.
On our first album, we proved that jazz originated in Ireland. This is a little bracket called The Sunshine of Your Slides.
Okay, here we go.
Oh dear, butterfingers. Here we go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
she's buying a stairway to heaven.
Oh, thanks. Now, thank you. We've been hearing a lot of bluegrass played over the weekend, and there's been a couple of people who can really sing it well, like Ziggy.
Definitely not
a moment. We actually specialise in that low morbid sound, which is, that's a lot of fun, really. It's very depressing music, but I think this one really. I think the one that's entitled "Singing Through My Nose."
Oh right.
This is a good song, actually. It teaches you all how to sing bluegrass, and who better to teach you than
moi? Moi. We heard that joke. There's a joke going around. Go and see Chris. The punchline is moi. I'm not going to say it. This is a family group.
But actually, it's not true. For those who
didn't have
joke.
He insisted it's a food.
Okay,
we're in tune.
Yeah, actually, can I put a capo on? We're just being held up by that gangster of bluegrass music, Al Capo. Sorry. Doesn't get any better, actually. See, I heard a new joke the other day, but I'm not going to tell it.
G4. Singing through my nose, singing through my nose. Thing that I love best is singing through my nose. Tennessee. My mom and dad weren't dead yet, they lived along with me. Saturday night we'd sit up, hear the grand old opera show. That's when I first heard someone singing through their nose. It was the greatest sound I heard, thought it was just wild. I asked my daddy about it, and he looked at me and smiled. Very next day he bought me a record of Bill Monroe, the great Bill Monroe. That's when I first started singing through my nose. Singing through my nose, singing through my nose. I get a lonesome feeling from my head down to my toes. I've known lots of pleasures, Lord only knows. But the thing that I love best is singing through my nose and picking a bit of hot guitar. Out on this lonesome road, I drink lots of coffee and I wear cowboy clothes and sometimes shorts to show off my legs. But the very thing I should have done was the bluegrass road I chose, 'cause the thing that I love best is singing through my nose. Singing through my nose, singing through my nose. I get a lonesome feeling from my head down to my toes. I've known lots of pleasures, Lord only knows. But the thing that I love best is singing through my nose. I'm picking up my mandolin.
Don't blow it.
Don't despair, if your life don't feel complete, and all your tribulations just lead you to defeat. There's a simple answer, forget all your cares and woes. Whenever life gets troublesome, try singing through your nose. Singing through my nose, singing through my nose. I get a lonesome feeling from my head down to my toes.
I've known lots of pleasures, Lord only knows. But the thing that I love best is singing through my nose.
Hi, thank you, friends and neighbours. What are we going to do?
Yeah, I think we might do...
We've got a whole list down here and we just can't make up our minds.
That's
only because we can't read. Somebody wrote it out for us.
All night.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is one, an old Bob Wills classic, which we completely destroy, called Stay All Night. It's a bit of Western swing for you.
Ready?
Yep.
One, two, one.
Just a few cup of teas between that one, that's for sure.
What do you think? Radio boy?
Yeah, that'll be a nice one.
Well, I got me a hat, got no guitar, brand name and payment on a second hand car. Got me a job on the radio, and I'm saving up money on a fiddle and a bow. Do the radio boogie, follow the dial. It's solid kick and red hot liquids, Tennessee style. Morning when the sun comes up, we'll cough in the jug and have a little suck. Sun keeps shining up while the farm, it starts to
rain, I'll just grind it in the barn. Do the radio boogie all over the dial, with a solid kick and a red hot lick, stands in style. Gal on the telephone, what you and honey, are you all alone? Come on over an hour or so and bump to the boogie on the radio. Do the radio boogie all over the dial, with a solid kick and a red hot lick, it stands in style. To spend everybody everywhere we play, do the radio boogies, old lake and say, do the radio boogie all over the dial, with a solid kick and a red hot lick, it's Tennessee style. Do the radio boogie all over the dial, with a solid kick and a red hot lick, it's Tennessee style.
We do have some tapes down here if you want to see us.
Tony Hunter and Dave O'Neill. It's a long way to come. I think it was worth it.
Thank you.
That's a good way. You'd use it in a lot of tunes. Maybe. What is that? Something rag, wasn't it? Fiddle player would do a shuffle, so it's slightly different. It was more. And so, but transferred to guitar, yeah, that's a. Doesn't work quite as well. The guitarist, Doc Watson, people like that, changed it to going the other way. So it's just across three strings, and it's important to alternate. A lot of people, a couple of people do it well going down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down. But the majority of people who do it alternate strictly. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. So if you're just doing it off that C shape. Got an idea on that? Mm.
Is
that
what is it like a roll? Is it like down, up, down, up, down?
I'm strictly alternating. If you're doing a one bar roll, it's. That'd be a one bar roll. A two bar roll would be. So you've got to clean it up.
Any techniques for stopping rolling with your pick?
Rolling with your pick?
Rather than chop it up and down like that, rather than something with it roll.
Anywhere, it's just that roll. So you can change your top string, or you can change your bottom string, you know. So they're sort of to actually work out a melody on it, it takes a little while, and you've really got to work on getting that melody coming out. A lot of experimenting. The other good technique is floating, which is where you're using notes up the neck as well as open strings. The classic lick being. So that's. that's, there's a lot of things you can do with that. You can use cross picking. So, sorry?
Classic lick slowly?
Yeah, sure. Okay. So, basically, I'm working off the 7th fret. But we're starting on the 8th fret on the B string on the note G. It's a run in G. And you go G, then open first string, and then first finger on the 7th fret on the next string, on the 3rd string, so that'll... And then open 2nd string. Then your 2nd finger rolls over onto the 4th string. And you walk across the 7th. So you're going... Okay, now it's important when you're doing floating that you actually walk it. Don't go with one finger, okay? Because you get, the whole idea is that the notes ring into each other. So you've got to walk across there, all across the 7th fret. So you can extend that up your G scale. Quite nice. I'm just walking across like that. It's great for like blues licks, as you get it. There happens to be a tune on our tape. That's a good point, Tony. Thank you very much, Doug. Yeah. Which goes up. That's for a bluesy type run. If you're doing, let's see if I can remember how to play this. You can use it quite effectively to play fiddle tunes. It is beautiful, yeah. There's a tune called Town and Country Fiddler by Howdy Forrester. I've just got to see if I can, I haven't played it for ages. Hey? Sure. Thank you. look at what I'm doing slowly there. It's going. So there's heaps of. What am I doing? Yeah, there's just. I'm using that effect for the whole. Pretty well the whole tune. It makes nice little fills in the middle of tunes too, to do it. Tony Rice uses those type of style, like the open floating style, a lot. So using it in a tune, just using it for fills is effective. Anything else? Questions?
They suggest, like, if you're going to learn bluegrass, like, flat,
then
you learn all your scales first. And
you really need, you need scales G, C, and D. And you need your blues scales. They're your main ones. You mainly work out an open G shape or an open C shape.
Can you demonstrate that?
Sure. In the key of, like, if G would be. Scale around it, you can use just a straight pentatonic. Pentatonic with a flat 3 as well. So that's adding a B flat. Add a flat 7 as well. Add a major 7th as well. Yeah, I mean, for in G, I mean, I find the most handy ones are the open one here. Moving up into this area. And up, this one up here. Okay, they're all really. There's a lot of licks found in those positions. You can go through, I mean, there are 7 main shapes for a major scale that you could use, but just get a few. Those ones are handy ones, and just work on licks in those. In C, the thing with bluegrass is you've got a major scale with a flat 7th, and you're adding the flat 3rd, and occasionally sharp 5. No, flat 5, sorry. So in the key of G, that's your B flat. In the key of C, you've got a C major scale plus an E flat. Any questions? What do you want? Bluegrass, swing?
Swing.
Swing.
Bluegrass.
You're not asking for much, are you? Here's a quick trick around the world. Jesus. Okay. No, I think because Bill Munro died recently, I think we should do a Bill Munro tune. I think that's very important. We haven't done one today. This is one called Road to Columbus. It's a great tune. Thank you. anybody's got any questions on anything we've covered, or you just want some help with anything, just grab me over the weekend. I'll just be wandering around. More than happy to help you out.
Well, took all that in. You remember it all?
Yes.
You know, if you're lucky to get one little lick, I think you're doing well. So now it's Tony Hunter's turn for mandolin.
Oh, mandolin.
So everybody rush out and get your mandolin.
The bluegrass, please. What I do is I just do the ordinary G chord. And then on the top two strings, you can see that. The first step you're after is just the ordinary G chord. Then you get a third finger on the fifth fret on the D string to get a G, and then on the seventh fret, which will give you another D on the bottom G string. And when you play that, this is what the standard Bill Munro invention. I'd say Bill Munro, the first person who really used chop chords, isn't it? I can't think of anybody else is. He created this chord just to give him that percussive attack. I mean, the bluegrass, the primary function of the mandolin is to sit there and play that, the snare beat, as it's called. I mean, you're substituting it for what the snare drum does in basic music, really, which is just keep strong two and four. One, two, three, four, one. But you can't really do that unless you've got all the strings covered. You know, there are a number of chords that could do this. I could also do it like this if I wanted to. I find this one a little bit. What I'm doing here, but to get the same top chord effect here, is I'm playing a D chord, but it's barred with the first finger at the fifth fret. And that chord, just like a record. I'll go into this one here, which I use from time to time. As you can hear, once you add that high B and it starts to get a little bit. A little bit non-bluegrass. I mean, you really need the top note to be a G to get. And you can just hear it just sounds right. This is it. You can hear it just starting to sound a little bit too on top. Another way. So I feel what I'm actually doing is a tantrum three and four. So I'm thinking down, chuck, down, chuck, down, chuck, down, chuck. So I'm actually doing a tantrum downstroke on the beats that I'm not playing, and that really helps you lock in solid to the two and four. If you can actually feel that, you're actually feeling that downstroke on the notes that you're not playing. If I was playing straight four downs, I'd be going. Bluegrass rhythm. Let's try that. This time we'll do the chorus. I'll blues get in hush.
All right.
Yeah. This time I'll do it. What I'll do is I'll do the verse. It's a standard bluegrass, and then on the chorus I'll go into a more contemporary rhythm mandolin space. That's the chorus. So one, two, three. There's a well. In a duo situation, I mean, it's definitely, in certain spaces, it just gives you something, an extra colour to work with, you know, but it's really hard to explain. I mean, it's really, it's something you would have to sit down and be aware of to get that feel. I mean, you've got to actually be feeling your hand just going standing, you know, just up and down. You've got to have to spend a lot of time just practicing doing rhythms like that. Thank you. Other styles I do, mandolin is a great funk instrument. It's really good funk music. Again, I demonstrate using those two new chords I showed you, the C7 and the D7 chord. The shape, yeah. I call it. Thinking in 6/8, you're thinking in a different space again. This time I'm thinking just. That's the rhythm I'm thinking of. So I'm going down, up, 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 down. So as I was doing the down and up really loudly, that was the accent I'm thinking up. Because I'm just thinking down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. You've really got to catch that accent. How do I explain this? Because otherwise you just end up playing 6/8 notes in a row. 6/8 notes in a row just isn't the rhythm I'm thinking of, but the rhythm I'm thinking of is da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, which is triplets. I'm thinking triplets rather than 6/8 when I'm playing it. Sort of a hybrid cross picking idea. I was going to get on to cross picking, but so.
This is just
free. Hi, Mum. Hi, Dad. How are you going? James here.
Hold it still.
Hold it still. Right.
Hold it still.
You got it?
Yes, we got it. Smiling faces.
Smiling faces. Tony, what?
Oh, sorry.
This is free advertising. Right.
Yep.
Hi, Dad.
Go, talk.
Would you buy a cassette off these, man?
What's on it?
What's on it? All sorts of delicious recipes.
Yeah, well.
This one's on it.
Wow, Tony, that's great. Is there any more?
And just so we know who to ask for when we go in.
When we go into the shops to look for it, it's David O'Neill, Tony Hunter, and Backerberg Backstep, available at the local discount shop.
And for a final song, a second one for Orange.
Can we have a big hand for Tony Hunter?
What do you want? Thank you.
Lay down. Thank you. Go.
Thank you.
Don't give your heart to a rattler, little girl. boxcars as they rattle on down the line. Don't fall in love with me, darling, I'm a rambling.
Terry, that was the best mandolin solo I've heard in a long time.
And I made that up all by myself.
Yeah?
See, it was the wrong notes at all. It was almost up to speed, too. I'll give you the money after.
Any faster than you? You all sing along with this. Liars!